Next, I want to show you how to import data from a SQL Server connection, or maybe from another ODBC data source. So perhaps you have a larger database back at work. Maybe it's an Oracle, or MySQL, or SQL Server, or something like that. Well, we can import that data right into an Access database. So in this case, what you're going to do is pick on external data. Now, you're going to find the category that's called More. Click on that pull down. And notice there's, we can even do Lotus 1-2-3, Paradox files, DBase files, even from Microsoft Outlook. You can import from an HTML web page. But here's one that says ODBC. Now, if you import the data, it'll make a copy of the data in the Access database. But if you, when you import, if you change it in Access, it will not update the ODBC database. And if you change the ODBC database, it will not update Access. They're two distinct copies. However, if you do a link, then if you update it in Access, it'll also update in the original database and vice versa. We're just going to do an import. We'll click on OK. Now, in order to make this work, you have to set up what is called an ODBC driver for that database. You probably already have that set up. If not, your IT team can help you with that. Now, probably in the next couple weeks, I'm going to have a video that's going to show you how to set up an ODBC driver in Windows 7. We probably won't have that right away, but I'll have that for you in a little while. But I'm going to go in the machine source here. And here's the ODBC drivers that I have for this computer. Again, you're going to coordinate this step perhaps with your IT team, because they will usually set those up for you. So when you go into this list back at work, you're going to see a different list that's different for each computer. So I have this one that's called Connection 1, and basically it's to a SQL Server database that I have on this computer. So I want to pick on Connection 1 and click on OK. Now, sometimes you would need a username and password. Again, you're going to coordinate that with your IT team. We'll pick an OK. Now, Access is trying to get to that larger database. And now you can see I can start to get to the objects in that larger database. So, in this case, I'm going to pick a table that's called the Order Master. And I can get to any one of these tables. If I wanted to pick more than one table, I can pick more than one like that. Or, of course, you can even do a select all. But I probably wouldn't do that because you might have a lot of different tables there that you may or may not need. So I'll just pick the few that I need. I'll pick an order master. We're going to click on OK. And it actually imported that into the Access database. Now, in this case, it says all objects were imported successfully. Do you want to save the import steps? If we save the import steps, then we can automate that process just do it in one or two clicks. And you can see we can give that a name and the description. We can even make it so that it schedules that in Outlook as a repetitious task. But we're going to save import. And now you're going to see a new table there that's called DBO underscore order master, because that was the name that it had in the SQL Server. If I double click on that, then there's the data. Okay, so the trick there was we picked an external data, more, ODBC database. Then if you pick on either import or link, then it's going to go and check out the ODBC drivers for your computer. So again, coordinate that with your IT team. They'll show you how to set that up, or they'll set that up for you, or it may already be on your computer. All right? That's how we can go from SQL Server or any other ODBC database into Microsoft Access.